single item per box playthrough real... It's going a lot easier than I thought it would. So, that's a good thing. And I don't have enough money for anything right now. I'm so used to having a couple of life savings in my... Okay. So, fall damage procs the panic mines, that's neat. It's gonna get real annoying on this level. You know what, I think some enemies are actually smarter than others, and the smart ones will attack you instead of your turret. That seems like, what's going on. I have almost 200 hours in this game, and I still have trouble, like, remembering what most of the items do. Alright, another monster tooth. Oh no. Alright. The parents and the children are so... I feel like they're some of the toughest ones for me. I don't know why. Feels like they don't do anything different than most of the other enemies. Maybe it's just a mental thing. Okay. Go away. Oh, jeez. Okay. I just want the items. And the parents can actually attack you if you're on the edge of the cliff like that. So... Don't stand on the edge of the cliff trying to attack the parents, because they will get you. And so will these stone golems, see? So that's one thing that you have to watch out for. Like, if you think you're safe, you're standing there on the edge attacking him, and then all of a sudden he just does half your health in one hit. How do you get up there? Calling the drones. Oh. Actually, the plants are doing less damage than the golems. That's weird. Have I found any boxes yet? I feel like there have been, like, no boxes. Okay, there's a small one. Let's see. Oh, jeez. That's no good. Just want my happiest mask. Oh, monster tooth, yeah. See, one thing I'm worried about is once I do finally go fight Providence, it'll be really tough because of my lack of damage and the lack of use of being able to use monsters too, because the only things I'll be able to kill are the temple guardians and the gilded worms. But maybe by that time I'll have enough stacks on monsters to just completely heal from anything that hurts me. And that's no good. But my main drones are down, so that's no good. Okay, these panic mines are helping out a lot. Ooh, there's more than I thought there. Okay, there we go. Ah, now I want the box. Oh, and there's nothing here that'll activate those, unless I can get the imp. Come on. Okay. Oh, jeez. I'm not very happy right now. Come on. Over here. Oof, that was a lot of damage. Now let's see if I can get these guys cleared out and get the box in both of my drones. God, there's so many of them here. I do no damage. Oh, drones and turret. Okay. It'll be a lot easier. Okay, more children spawned. Cool. Let's do this. Get that. Get that. Okay. Monsters too. That was not worth it, honestly, taking all that time just to get the monster's tooth. Oh no. Or maybe this might be good. Drop the mines. There we go. But you know what? No, that wasn't actually a good idea. I lost both my drones and... Yeah, I can't get them because there's just way too many up there. Oh! Okay. That's weird. Nothing over here. I think the teleporter was all the way on the other side. Let's see if I can grab that and maybe get a red item from the boss. There we go. This is one of my least favorite levels, just because you have to go around and there's no easy way to get from one side of the map to the other. Okay. Oh, where is it? Where's the teleporter? Always lose it. There's a box. Yes, teleporter is up here. No big boxes, I don't think, but I did get a green item from this small box. That's good. Yeah, this healing already, just with 7 snacks, I think, what is that? 40 health. Get another panic mine, because if I do, that should do that. Where are my panic mines? Oh, they're there. Okay. If I stand right here, he should get hit. Yeah. Let me wait for all my mines to come back up. Getting hit. Okay. Oh. Oh, that wasn't even the boss. Wow, okay. This is gonna be tough. Okay, let's just activate that. Hope for a Wandering Vagrant or a Colossus. Swear to God, if I get a third magma worm in a row. Oh, ancient. That's not good. It's worse than the magma worm. Okay. Where is it? I cannot find the ancient wisp. Okay, there he is. Ow. Okay. Let's see if I can get close. Drop my panic mines. Come on, panic mines. Come on. There we go. Okay. This is not going well. If I can... Oh, he's dead. Okay. There's a lot. Oh, yeah. spawns the big wisps and the tiny ones. But that's no problem because my panic mines deal tons of damage.
Follow me.
Oh, okay. Maybe I should have gone for a different use item. Thinking disposable missile launcher would have been better. Again. You know what, maybe this isn't that much of a challenge, honestly. I thought this would be a lot harder than it actually is. We took care of 33 left. Maybe if I just get in the middle of them and drop a bunch of panic mines, it'll kill them that quick. Let me go this way. There we go. Drop the bunch, come back down here. If I go this way, the golem should... Come on. Okay, cool. They don't even last for that long. But I'm gonna go up here. There we go. Okay, now that I'm getting the hang of how panic mines work, it's a lot easier to be able to trigger them at the right time. See, this is where a disposable missile launcher would come in very handy. Can I get him from here? Yeah, but I don't want to wait on that. Got the mines. There we go. Ooh, finally. So yeah, I expect these episodes to be getting shorter and shorter as I progress through all the individual levels, because it will get easier for me to just run, grab the chests, and then activate the teleporter. It'll probably only be like 5 to 10 minutes per episode. So yeah, that was episode 2. That took a lot shorter time, it felt like, but I will see you next time in the Sunken Tombs.